I made a video around a week ago about a YouTuber called Jack Doherty, probably the worst content creator currently on the platform. And that's not hyperbole, I promise. He is actually the worst content creator I have personally seen on the platform. In my video, I mainly covered his video, which consisted of him going into a hotel lobby, walking around screaming and starting an argument with and insulting an older fella for like no reason. And watching this unfold is an utterly cringeworthy experience.
Sorry. I'm gay.
You're leaving.
Too bad, little man.
What happened?
Don't call me little man.
I will too.
Why?
You know my dad owns this place, right?
Wow.
Well, I don't want to be filmed.
Okay, well, just
stop looking.
You enjoy your last 10 years for a hospital.
So seriously, your dead parents are happy as shit.
You finish high school.
About, I don't know. It's
you know,
like,
he makes
I don't
more than both y'all
no, wait. Now, granted, his mate does come off far worse than he did. And I honestly had no idea who he was prior to making this video. So imagine my shock when I find out this dude right here is 34 years old. And hey, I'm not knocking his age. We're all getting older and there's nothing stopping the petrifying and constantly accelerating passage of time. But when I'm 34, I at least hope I'm not tagging along as some gassed up 20-year-old's hype man versus a pensioner. But this video is just the very tip of the Jack Doherty iceberg. So he makes videos for kids, but not just kids, stupid kids. Like proper set-haters. You know that one kid you had at your school that was such a little shit, he was basically permanently chained up in isolation like Hannibal Lecter? That is Jack Doherty's target audience. That's who he tries to appeal to. And oh my days, they were not happy that I made a video about their favorite YouTuber and kick streamer. I just love how he starts arguments and insults random people and then hides behind his bodyguards. He is truly the moron's champion. They all look up to him. Now, I was going to make a different video because, as I said, there's so many other Jack Doherty videos, and it wasn't until after I posted my video, I went back and watched some of his other videos and was like, actually, there's quite a lot of bad shit here. And I was just going to have this video be a part of that video, but I kind of just wanted to make a whole video about this. But yep, some of them left comments on my videos. A lot of them were stuff like,
don't talk to Jack like that. Don't diss my man, Jack. He's out.
Now, those were obviously like the same ones, but it was a very small handful of comments, you know, like defending Jack or whatever, but they're so brain rot inducing. And honestly, I was surprised at how many there were because his content can't even be considered subjectively good by anyone, except maybe the terminally stupid and chronically online. And by chronically online, I don't mean like Twitter chronically online. I mean like people that watch kick streams kind of chronically online. They're like opposite ends of the chronically online spectrum, you know? Now, usually I'm not asked if someone's fans who I've made a video about come and leave comments on mine, even if they're like, oh, you big pussy, why are you making a video on my favorite content creator? You should die. Because there may be some nuance and maybe their content just isn't for me, you know? But there is just nothing redeemable about Jack's content. It's horrible. Anyway, he joins YouTube after you and still got way more subs. What is that a measure of anything? What is that a measure of? He made a video going up to a pensioner and insulting him with like his cronies. What is that a measure of? I'm not calling him irrelevant. Actually, I did kind of do that. I said there's no need for him to have a bodyguard, and I stand by that. Dude gets like 100 to 300k views a video. It's literally no point other than like flexing to have a bodyguard if you get between 100 and 300k views a video. Plus, you're a commentary channel that hardly puts any effort. Now, I'm not gonna sit here and be like, oh, I slave over these videos. These videos take me ages. I've just screenshotted some comments and I'm reading them out for a video. These videos don't take me long. I don't get what you're trying to say here. Should I give up the commentary gig and go and harass some old people? Because yes, doing that might be higher effort content. I would have to get up and go to a hotel and find a pensioner to insult. But would that make my content better? I'm going to say I don't think so. At least he's contributing something, even if it's crap. What is he contributing? What on earth is he contributing? Actually, to be fair, he doesn't say if he's contributing something positive. He just says contributing something. And you're right, he is contributing something negative. How can you be in your near 30s? Your face like a shy child. Near 30. I would argue that, but I'm 25. So like rounded up, that is 30. So you know what? I will concede on that. Stay out my recommendations, Brit boy. No, I do what I want. I find it funny that everyone is hating on Jack. I'm pretty sure he just knows how content creation and attention spam works. I love how he words this as if like Jack is one of the only people in the world with this knowledge. I have this fucking knowledge. Anyone that has been doing YouTube full time for a number of years has this knowledge. The rest of us just don't go around being assholes to people. Do you know what I mean? He knows by acting the way he does, he keeps his videos / streams entertaining. So fucking what? What does that have to do with it? They're not, first of all, they're not entertaining. I'm ashamed to admit this, but the other day I sat down and watched a Jack Doherty stream, and it was probably the most boring thing I have ever seen in my life. He just sort of sat on his bed, smoked some weed, and like listened to people donate him money. It was the most dead shit ever. He also called someone's chain fake. That was an exciting bit. He pays almost everyone that's part of his streams and vids, which is the reason why his guests also act that way. I don't understand like these idiots' justification with, oh, like, they're getting paid, they're getting like attention and money and clout off this. So it's all right, that's why they're doing it. It's all right. Fucking idiots. He's just a smart kid making money, which he's investing in houses where we'll not really say. I love how he put money in all caps. But the thing is, making videos like that is stupidly short-term thinking, because no brands are going to want to work with that kind of person, are they? And once people in his audience reach their 14th birthday, they're going to realize that the shit he's doing just isn't entertaining or funny. He has no reason to hate. What do you mean no reason to hate? He's the one going around being an arsehole. Am I not allowed to call this out? Covers his face because he knows Jack's fans would beat the shit out of him, no cap. How delusional are you? Also, Jack's fans probably aren't even in secondary school yet. Even those Jack's fans would beat the shit out of him, no cap. Oh yeah, that's the reason why I cover my face, you know, because I think people's fans would beat me up. And I love that. I love that thing of like, oh, you wear the mask because you're scared. You're scared of like the fans and the creator coming and beating you up. That never happens. That never happens outside like shitty kick streams. Like stuff that happens online typically just stays online. I've never made a video about someone and then want to beat me up. That's mental. He followed that comment up with LMAO. Everyone's so jealous of a kid who made it. Yeah, man, I'm so jealous of his life. It looks so fun. Yo, grown-ups need to grow up and catch up to Jack. Brokey bitches always hate. I love how they just turn to this thing of like, yeah, well, you don't have as much money as him. You're a brokey. Yeah, but I don't have to make a twat on myself on live stream to make money. I count that as a W. But I hate that I just said that. I hate that I just said W. Bro, you're the loser making a video glazing. Doesn't glazing mean like you're essentially like sucking someone off? Like you're glazing them. All these comments are glazing this fucking 20-year-old. How am I the one glazing? I'm the one saying his videos are shit. This is a bit of an L video. Oh. Okay, I know I just said W. But I hate it when people refer to things as W or L. Like, just fucking shut up. Give your iPad back to your dad. Jack Doherty is a self-made millionaire, despite if he's cringe. Why do they bring it back to their money? What does that have to do with anything? Well, I'm not allowed to say his videos are shit if he's a millionaire. Oh, sorry. Okay, I know this... This is a bit of a mental comparison. I'm not even going to call it a comparison. But that's like going, oh yeah, you know, Jeffrey Epstein did all those bad things, but he is a self-made billionaire. The bias in this video is just not fair. How was I biased? I just said what I was thinking. What do you mean biased? I'm not biased one way or the other. You stream every day and try to be entertained. There was nothing wrong in the last clip. Okay, so this is referring to a clip where there was this this dad who had taken his kids out on a day out, and Jack was like walking out of the police station because he just, I don't know, won a case or something, going, oh, we did it! Mofo, he's screaming and shouting down the street, and this dad was like, oh, can you stop?
We got out of there, mofo, let's go. I didn't say any curse words. What'd I say?
Just watch your language.
What'd I say?
Why would he apologize for something he didn't do? If you think apologizing for no reason is what you should do, then you are a bitch. I mean, I don't think I'm a bitch for thinking, just going, oh, sorry, mate, instead of starting an argument with a guy just taking his kids on a day out. I think that's just the wisest thing to do. If you think getting into confrontation with people at every opportunity is a good idea, I'm sorry, there is no way you're an adult. There's no way you're an adult. Oh, and then we got a load of comments like, calling someone a coward while hiding your own face. No one cares what a coward behind a mask has to say. At least he isn't afraid to show his face. Again, I love the afraid comments, as if I'm afraid Jack Doherty is going to come up to me and beat me up or something. This guy makes a living off making fun of people while covering his face. I mean, yeah, kind of, but you're making it sound like it wasn't deserved. Like I'm punching down or something, as if I'm not like taking the piss out of as a lot of these people say, self-made millionaire who is going around being a dick in the name of entertainment. He hides behind his bodyguard and you hide behind your mask and glasses, L take. Yeah, I mean, I would still say I'm less of a coward. Okay, now this next comment, it's not something necessarily to do with Jack. It's just a comment that I get a lot and it really annoys me. Commentary guy is mad annoying, interrupts the clip every 2 seconds. What do you want me to do? Do you want me to play the whole video? I get this comment on like the videos where I watch like movies and TV shows. Like, do you realize if I just showed the whole thing, that would be copyright infringement. Like, if you want to watch the video, go and watch the video. It is readily available for you to watch. Bro, whole YouTube is using other people content. Yeah, well, you didn't use the right grammar, did you? But yeah, anyway, I just wanted to make a video about these comments because I don't know, I thought they were rather amusing. amusing. I can subscribe or Jack Doherty's fans will come and beat me up. Please, please do it. I don't want them to come and beat me up.